Hey, Rusty Russ, what's going on here, bro? I just see I have a friend who slept with another friend's girl. I caught them in the act without I caught them in the act without them seeing me. I'm going to get them all in one.
You peeping Tom.
You peeping Tom.
You pervert. How did you catch them in the act?
How did you catch them in the act? All three of them in one room and confront them. Okay.
Oh, was it a party thing?
Yeah, so what? So basically, Rusty, because you're in the comment section, let's have a little more clarity on this.
Yeah,
so
if it's a party thing, Rusty, you're cool. Like, if you.
So
you know,
your friend is one of your boys that slept with your other boy's girls, yeah? And you caught them in the act, but they didn't see you doing it, yeah? So what you saying that, rah, you're on a thing that my man's foul for doing what he's done, and like, you're on a thing of catching them out. You get what I'm saying? And, yeah, it was a party. Yeah, he's saying it was a party.
Yeah, it was a party thing.
Yeah.
Them ones. So what's he going to do? What he's saying? He's going to get them all in the room and just blow it up.
Blow it up.
And they're all friends.
Yeah.
His hands are tied. Rusty, you got to do what you got to do.
You got to do
what if they're all your friends, yeah, you might as well. You can't. If you keep quiet, then you're complicit. You're part of it.
Yeah.
So that's the problem. Now, yeah. So yeah, probably the only thing is to kind of, yeah, just blow it up. Say, listen, I saw you grinding you're meant to be with him. You know. The man them should really just, it is what it is. Hopefully, the man that was grinding the bread as girl will tell him even before you can even tell him. That's what you should be doing, just telling him, and then we can all get along and the girl's just out the door.
Yeah, because that's some foul shit.
Rashid, stick to media stuff, man.
Yeah, Rashid, yeah. Codes, man.
Nah, there's a bro code. It's a bro code.
Like, put it this way.
Because it's the man them, like, if it's your girl and your brethren there smashes your girl, and I know, and we're all friends. How's it snitching if I say, like,
yeah? Because you got to understand, that's foul shit behavior.
Foul shit, blood. There's a code.
So if my brethren, there's honor. If my brethren's gonna start fucking my other brethren's girl, there's no telling what this brother could do. This brother could rob from man. This brother,
he's not really loyal to the. He's not loyal to the gang.
Yeah, he's not loyal to the man them. So at the end of the day, he's lucky. This brother's lucky that he's saying he's just calling it out. He's all due to call it out and man start bracking up his brethren.
Huh? Yeah, if he tells his brethren, then he's done him a favour.
Yeah.
But it's not really a favour in that sense, but I get what he's already done the deed.
Really? If my girl
comes to him, The girl's trash. The man them should just be, he should just come and say, listen, your girl's trash, bro.
She tried to move to man.
Man beat it still, but... she's trash. And I had to show you she's trash.
And I had to stop. And
yeah, like, she's trash. But me and she's persistent. 30.
And I see why you got with her, because she's persistent and all that. Yeah,
and then you just move. And then it's, she's out and the man them can still move. Bad. So yeah, that's what I'd say to that.
Also, RIP, Brazilian artist, falls to his death, trying to hide from his wife after having a threesome.
I saw that online a few weeks ago. Man, them are putting it up like they know the Brazilian artist.
This is what I'm saying. I didn't know who he was either. But listen, we'll talk about it. We talk about some cheating shit. The subject of cheating, that's what we got here on the old laptop.
Yeah, we're going heavy on that today.
We're going heavy on that by the looks of things. Listen, the cheating thing's nuts, man. Cause look at this. Man lost his life off of the back of that. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, to save himself from getting caught from his wife, lost his life. It's better he just got caught.
Well, clearly.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely that. Definitely better if he got caught than if he dived to his death.
Yeah, but it's a mad one. I don't know, man. It's a mad one. Like, listen, brothers, just handle your business. If you know you're out there doing whatever you're doing, innit? Just have your shit sewn up, innit? Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, man. It's just a bit of a... It's a hard one. And what? If you're with someone you really love, hold it down, innit? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, of course.
You know? But cheating is a mad one. You gotta elaborate on this one for us, Rashid, because you just chucked it out there, the subject of cheating. What is man really meant to say about cheating? Oh, you have one?
Yes, as we wait for Rashid to come in with another dilemma.
The next thing. I have a dilemma. Blessings to you, Pans and Dougster. I live in a toxic household with toxic, verbally abusive parents.
Sorry to hear that.
I can't move out just yet until I'm financially stable. I just got a new job and I'm saving so I can move out. Mm-hmm. How do I cope with constant bullying?
Was that from Rashid? We're going to sort you out, Rashid. You're going to be all right. Everything's going to be A-okay.
Don't worry, we got you.
Everything's going to be just fine.
That's a mad one still. That's a mad one.
He was about to move out, but the Betty Banks P kind of pushed him back.
Pushed it back a bit.
A little piece. I mean, but we're going to be all right. We're going to be all right. But yeah, anyway, no, in all seriousness now. That sounds like a bad situation there. Mm. You have to try and find your own peace in amongst the madness somehow. When you close your bedroom door, you just zone out, put your headphones on, maybe listening to some music, separate yourself, find a way to find some peace in the midst of the chaos. You understand? Whether it's going gym, whether it's going for runs, whatever it is, you got to try and find a way to find some inner peace and in your mind know that like this too shall pass, better times are going to come.
Yeah.
And just visualize that. Just think to yourself, okay, I'm in this now, but I know where I'm heading to. It sounds like you've got a plan to me already, so just stick to your plan, keep pushing, keep moving forward, and keep the plan alive.
Yeah, definitely.
Zone out the noise. Zone out from what they're saying and what's going on. As for the bullying, you know who you are, so just, be strong within yourself and try and get out of there when you can.
And it's mad, because when it comes from parents and that people you look up to and love, it's hurtful as well. And it's easier to say not to hold grudges or not to feel a certain type of way about it because it's coming from your family, innit? But like Pan said, you got to kind of find some kind of like place where you can find, is it solace? The word that I'm looking for, like chill.
Good word, Doug.
And have your own little thing in amongst the madness that when you get out and you can get away from it, then you can kind of build on your life again, innit? But also to keep in mind that the reason why you're there. Yeah, you know, sometimes some people live in certain households or certain situations that they don't want to be in. Like, the place could be dusty and they have to be there for a certain extent till they get enough money to get out and things like this, or bad abusive or just whatever. Just remember the reason why you're there and what your goal is and what your aim is.
It's a means to an end.
That's it. That is it, man.
And we move. What's the laptop saying apart from that? Shout out to loud.co.uk.
Come on. My man's back to the cheating. If a man cheats on his girlfriend nonstop, does he have a pass to return? Does she have a pass to return the favor? No. No, but at the same time, these girls are going to do whatever they feel they need to do, innit? What was it? I see something. I can't even talk about it.
I know you was thinking that. And let's be clear. It's nothing to do with me or Doug. It's just something that we've got coming in the episode coming up.
Yeah, I can't even talk about it.
Yeah, we're not going to talk about that for now. We'll hear that out at a later stage. But does it give the woman the pass? No, because they've got to be better than us. But if you man are cheating 24/7, you man need to exhibit some more impulse control, have a bit more about yourselves.
Yeah.
You know, it's not everything. It's not everything you have to fuck, innit? I've said this before, like.
It's not
every girl that flipping, you know, arouses your loins that you have to go and grind. Take time sometimes and just, you know, have a bit of value to yourself. Get a bit of self-control, a bit of discipline.
That's why
if you man can't control it with that, what else can't you control it with? What else you gonna do? You're going to snitch, you're going to snake. Have a little bit of self-control, blood.
Little self-control. And also, listen.
Because that's a draw, right?
And sometimes, be real to yourself. You see, some of the time, man are cheating. And man are certain man are in these situations that they're settling in a relationship that they're with a girl they don't really particularly want to be with, looking for shelter, doing whatever you're on. Listen, just walk away, man. Just leave the girl alone and go and do your thing. Like, because at the end of the day, if you're being serious, half of the time, sometimes I know certain men have been with girls that they're not really, that's their girl, but they're not 100% got the, you know what I mean, the bit about them to get up and leave and go about their business. So they want to slide and grind on a down low.
Yeah, but some men as well, just what he's saying is some men can't just look into slam everything.
Yeah, that as well.
They like their girl and they like everything else as well. You know, like that. That's what I think he's asking about. But does he give a pass for the females? No, because I think they're better than us. They have to be better than us.
Mm-hmm.